Modern Wahine Hawaii is presented by Inspiration Interiors, home fashion with an attitude. I'm Brooke Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Aloha and welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. Today's show is all about inspirational beauty. We headed to Waikiki to visit with Huguette Montesinos Rodriguez, who is the CEO of Dysfunction Magazine, to hear her story. Take a look. I'm here with Huguette Montesinos Rodriguez of Dysfunction Magazine et al. So many other things to talk about. How are you?
I'm doing wonderful. How are you?
I'm good. I feel like I need to be introduced to said couch.
Her name is Petunia.
Hello, Petunia.
Yeah, Petunia loves to be involved in everything life of mine and one of my favorite colors, so she just had to be part of this.
Ah, okay. Like a touchstone, if you will.
Absolutely.
Thanks for being here as well, Petunia. Let's start with Dysfunction Magazine because it was your baby here in Hawaii, and then it went worldwide. So let's talk about that first.
Dysfunction started 10 years ago. And as you mentioned, it was a local publication. And I always knew that when starting this movement, it was something that was going to go a little bit further just because I was always a little geographically unstable. So I wasn't sure.
In a good way.
I wasn't sure where I'd end up, but Hawaii has always had my heart. So it started locally. And then within a year, year and a half or so, it became national and then expanded to international. And so this movement, I call it more of a movement because the magazine itself has just been one of the pillars. And so through that, it's kind of expanded and grown into, you know, multifaceted things such as programs and talks and events and things
like
that.
And so for people who don't understand like the philosophy behind Dysfunction, because when people think about fashion magazines or magazines in general, there's a sort of, you know, an insinuation that goes with that, which is nothing that of what Dysfunction is about.
Right, absolutely. Yeah, it's actually a counterculture movement. And so I remember when starting the movement, one of the things that I felt like I needed and just wanted to see was media that represented women for who they were, not who they were supposed to be. Mm-hmm. And basically, most of what we see in media is looking at the world from the outside in and trying to replicate that. And so the idea with Dysfunction, with this movement as a whole, was to look inside and then replicate that and externalize that into the outside world. And so I feel like a lot of women are just so empowered and infused with so much greatness, and a lot of times they're not letting that out because so much of their world is being impacted by what they're being told and sold.
Right.
And so that was really the heart of starting this counterculture movement.
Got it. And so when it went global, what were the next steps? Because, you know, you put work out there and then it becomes what it's going to become. How do you hold on and where do you ride it to?
I've always held on to the process with a very light grip. And so whatever journey this was supposed to become, I think that's where my spiritual life really comes in. Mm-hmm. And I feel like there are numerous purposes throughout our lives and there are seasons. And so with the magazine, it's really been like, well, as long as this season needs to exist, we're just gonna ride it out. And you know, even the transition of it right now, going from print to digital to all the different aspects of what we're doing now, it's just been something that I just need to kind of go with the flow, go with the process, and not hold on to anything too tightly, because I feel like that can also be a space of confusing my own identity with what I do. Mm. And that's something that I'm so against.
Yes.
Is that what you produce equals your worth. And so I want to make sure that I live that out as I'm preaching the same message.
Right. And how do you do that? Because I think that's really at the core of what most human beings go through, especially when they create things, put it out in the world, is how do you check yourself and say, well, now maybe I'm getting a little bit muddled on what I'm confusing myself, who I am and what I do.
Right, absolutely. I think that's where creating something out of this idea that it's not a representation of who I am, but it's a representation of who God is through me. Mm. And so it's a constant check. I'm not gonna say it's easy, because
right.
It really is just checking your mind, recalibrating your heart every single day, mm-hmm. and saying, regardless of what the results are, what I produce is not contingent on that.
Right, what are you working on now? Like, or what's coming up here in 2020?
One of the things that I know I'm really called to this season is particularly talking about the joy of resilience and the joy of being able to live a life that's not always under our control. So I'm actually working on something called the Anxiety Fast 2020, where we end the anxiety around several different areas of our lives and different part of our lives. So I think resilience is such a key factor, and that's why I mentioned that word numerous times. It's been a word that has come up numerous times for me in building a life of joy, because it's not something that happens because of your circumstances or something that allows you know, perfect people with perfect lives. It's really how you choose to transition through the difficulties. And so resilience is such a big part for me. And building a life of joy is also embracing sacred play. And sacred play is almost like a cuss word in our culture nowadays, because it's like, you mean what?
Right.
Play?
Right.
Free time? Hang out?
Right.
No, we're so stuck to our phones, we're on email all the time, we're so busy. And this word busy, to me, is a personal offense. And so I think it's kind of like shifting gears and taking what in culture is really cool, which is being busy and always being up to something, to saying, no, you know what, I'm gonna flip that upside down. Sacred play is so essential.
So how do you define joy?
You know, I would say that joy is living in a state of celebration in spite of circumstances, not because of them. And so that was something that came alive for me when I started going through so many different difficult times in my life. So from a young age, my father was never really around, so I had a very hard time connecting. Later on into my life, I got married and divorced, which is what originally brought me to Hawaii. And through the years, also going through an autoimmune disease called Crohn's disease. And you know, just being able to say, these circumstances are not going to define my life. God reminds me constantly that there's an open fiesta that I can join. And of course, you know, being a Latina, we love fiesta, we love food, we love party. So I was like, I'm gonna join God's fiesta in spite of all these circumstances. And so that's been part of my journey, which is why also one of the resources that we have available through the website and our Instagram account is the Radical Joy Toolkit. It's something that I want everyone to experience. And I talk about all the things that are a soul drain versus things that are a joy train. And so when we discuss that, I talk about all the joy train elements and how to actually implement that into your life, because I also like to be very actionable. We have so much information nowadays, and a lot of times you're like, well, that's great, I'm glad I know that now. How do I apply that to my life? Mm-hmm. And so actionable steps is so important for me, so anyone can get that and just begin to jump on that joy train with me.
Well, that is amazing. Thank you so much for that information. We're all gonna have to look into it. 2020.
That's right. Time for joy.
Time for joy. Time for joy. Thanks so much. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. I'm here with Cora Spearman-Chang from Cora Dobros. Hi, Cora.
Aloha, Brooke.
And we have friends here with us. Let's explain to people, what is Cora Dobros?
Cora Dobros is a lifestyle brand made here in Hawaii, inspired by my family. So it's a modern aloha wear brand.
And how did you come upon wanting to do modern aloha wear?
I was in Japan, and then I came over on vacation, and then randomly, I was like, I'm moving to Hawaii before graduation.
Wow.
And I had a six-figure offer back at home, and I was like, I don't want to go work for a car company. I'm moving to Hawaii, where I had no job, knew no one, and my parents were like, you've honestly lost your mind. And I was like, nope, I'm moving to Hawaii, and I did, and that's how I ended up here. And that was over 20 years ago.
Wow.
But what I ended up doing was falling in love with a local boy.
Of course.
And yeah, they're so cute. And so I ended up seeing him, and literally it was love at first sight. We met at work, and so we ended up coming and communicating and talking, and he hasn't been able to get rid of me since.
And so with Cora Dobros, you know, your aesthetic is modern, obviously, with a Hawaii twist, but did you like see that there was a need for it in the market?
Or absolutely. We used to have retail stores at Ward before I was diagnosed with head, neck, and brain cancer. Mm-hmm. But at our retail stores, people used to always come in asking for kids, high-end kids aloha wear. And I couldn't find it anywhere. But then when I was battling cancer, I had a lot of free time on my hands. And I wanted to shift my focus to thinking about something that inspired me and gave me hope. And so I decided to create what everyone was looking for, within the hopes of one day having our own children.
Got it. Okay, so let's go back and talk about the cancer, because you battled cancer and won.
Yes, thank you.
So let's talk about, what kind of cancer did you have?
I had head, neck, and brain cancer. It is a weird, what they classified as a lipoid sarcoma, which is normally found in fatty muscle tissue of the arms or legs. And so they never usually find it in someone's head. Mm-hmm. But me being the overachiever
special,
that I am.
Special, yes.
I had to manifest it in my brain. And the doctors had to try to figure it out. So I was at Johns Hopkins. They were able to hone in on it and be extremely aggressive with the radiation. And so they couldn't figure out, all right, we've done all this radiation. Mm-hmm. So now I had what was called over-radiated narcosis, where you've over-radiated the body. And so it's not where you completely become an X-Man, but kind of in the sense that I had no blood flow to my face.
Wow.
So what they did was a partial mastectomy. Mm-hmm. They cut my right breast and pulled it up through my clavicle. And that is what created the tissue on this side of my face, but also gives me blood flow.
Wow.
It's called a pectoralis flap. I said, thank God I was born with triple D's. What was the A cup?
When
I
we
mean,
provide,
dead.
They provide. Yes.
Yes. God makes no mistakes.
That's amazing. How do you go from having battled back from cancer and all of the, you know, touch and go with that,
right,
to doing the line? Like, what kept you kind of going through all of that?
Well, what kept me going was the love of a great man. Mm-hmm. I have an amazing husband. My love, honestly, for God and his love, what I perceive his love for me. And focusing on a goal and a dream. I knew I wanted to, you know, create the brand and the line, but it gave me another focus. So instead of me focusing on, you know, cancer treatments and getting well and things not going right, mm-hmm. I was able to focus on a business plan that kept me goal-oriented on the future. Mm. And so I was always looking forward to something good,
right?
You know?
And so you were thinking about starting a family.
Yes.
And how did that all factor into the conversation? Because I'm sure people had their theories.
Right. Well, the doctors, well, the main thing about me and my personality, you tell me I can't do something.
Right.
I kind of like to
clearly
prove
yes.
it wrong. And so they were like, you can't have babies. I was like, watch me. But basically, no, it wasn't that easy. Honestly, it was at a point where I was already older. You know, I was in my, what they call maternal.
Yes.
Yeah.
Advanced maternal.
Yes.
Age, right?
Yeah, I don't like that word.
Yeah.
But I say you can't put an expiration on anything but milk, and even then it might still be good.
Right? You never know.
And you never know. You got to just taste it.
Right.
And so, but basically I ended up coming back home, and I got pregnant, and after losing two babies, mm-hmm. we had our two miracle babies. I call them my rainbow babies.
Aww.
We have Belle and Zoe. And Belle was born magically 10-10-10.
Wow. And so how did you balance, you know, your health, a new family, and core adorables? Like, how does that all matriculate? Like, how do you keep that wheel spinning?
For me, it's all the same thing. You know what I mean? Like, I started the brand in the hopes of having children. And the hopes and the goal was to create this brand for this niche that people said that they wanted in the market of mm-hmm. having kids' clothes. And so everything is related, you know? And so for me, it's like the kids are a major part of the brand.
Right.
The goal is to one day have them take over the company. But even if that's not their dream and that's not what they want to do, hopefully they can utilize that same skill set that they see mommy utilizing and that I'm teaching them in the future in whatever profession they choose.
Right, because they're watching you do it.
Trying to.
Right, demonstrating. So let's talk about the future of Core Adorables, because so many things. You had a really good Christmas. Let's drop names, shall we?
Oh, go ahead.
So the Smith family, and by Smith, we're talking
I'll
about...
I'll just pick that up right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, we're talking about Jada and Will Smith.
Oh, yes.
Some other notable people that have been wearing your stuff are...
You.
Why, thank you. Yes, this shirt dress is amazing, but let's talk about that ukulele shirt that you have, because... Oh. I believe you have an up-and-comer from the North Shore, lovely young guy, Jack Johnson.
That's right. I told him that I gifted him the mullet shirt. It's the reverse mullet. Party in the front, all business in the back with a falafel.
Well, thank you so much for being here and for telling us your story, because, you know, yes, the clothes are beautiful, but your whole story, your tenacity and your, you know, drive for you and your young daughters, it's very inspiring.
God bless you as well, sis.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we'll be with Inspiration Interiors. I'm here with Julia from Inspiration. Hi, Julia.
Hi.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
New Year, new set.
Exactly. So fun.
Let's get into it. What's going on here?
Yeah, so I figured for 2020, just because it's a new decade, might as well pull a lot of really fun and new and interesting items that we have. So we'll start with the coffee table. it comes in the black, and then it also comes in a white ash.
Oh, nice.
And then in two different sizes. So this is actually the shorter size. So we have one that's even longer. It's such a great statement piece, and just, it's so much for your eye. It just like attracts your eye.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then the wonderful armchair that you're sitting in, which
yes.
I absolutely love. We also carry it in a fabric, and we carry it in a sofa, a three-seater sofa and a two-seater sofa. It's called the Maralunga,
mm-hmm.
and how comfortable is it?
It is.
Just sitting in it right
it's
now,
like a
how
pillow.
Comfortable is it?
It really is a pillow.
It just, I mean, I feel like it really just like, it
folds
you
in.
Yeah. And the really cool thing uh-huh. about it, I'll actually get up and show you. And this is via a bicycle chain mechanism in the back.
Oh.
And it actually folds all the way down. If you want to sit up a little bit more
yeah.
and maybe host a show, you
right.
would probably have it down.
Right, like an origami chair of sorts.
It really is, and it's just super versatile. And also, this gray that we carry it in, I think it just kind of goes with everything, really.
Right.
You can pair it with any color. It can be that perfect piece for your living room.
Mm-hmm.
And then behind us, this is by a company, Icons Milano, and this is our high chest. I absolutely love it just because obviously this will be the statement piece
yeah.
in your home.
The graphics.
I love the colors. I love like that amber and then that light purple. I just think the way that they made it really just like it all flows together mm-hmm. even though it's so much. And then this is a Natuzzi sofa. Another beautiful leather piece that is just, it's so soft to touch. Also, the color I love this really soft mauve. I think
right.
it's just, it's really hot right now, and it also, it just lets you sit really comfortably. So
mm-hmm.
you could be watching TV, but you could also be, you know, having tea or coffee with your girlfriends or your mother-in-law, you know. I mean, it's
right.
really just made for...
And some people are afraid of pink, but, you know, this pink is not too feminine.
It's not.
Just very neutral pink.
It's such a perfect,
yeah.
it's such a perfect, nice, it's like a pale pink, you
yeah.
know? Yeah, yeah, so I absolutely love it. So yeah, and I think all of these pieces work really well together, somehow with the color and the
right.
flow. Yeah, I just thought it was a really nice 2020 little vignette.
Right.
Yeah.
Heading in a new direction for the new decade.
Exactly. Like, let's bring some color in it. Let's bring some fun in.
Well, thank you so much, Julia. This love this set.
Thank
it's
you.
Amazing. Very
thank
quirky
you.
And very me.
Yes.
Now we head over to Ulta Beauty to check out some wonderful products at every price point. Take a look. We're here with Amy Thomas at Ulta Beauty. Hi, Amy.
Hi.
I love this because we're talking about beauty at every price point. I'm a bargain girl. I love to get a good deal. So we're going to be talking about all the different price points.
Absolutely. You know, one of the things I think that is so unique about Ulta Beauty is we are all things beauty all in one place. We have more than 25,000 products in our stores and nearly 500 brands represented, really ranging from everything from your drugstore essentials to that high-end luxury, kind of thinking like high-low,
right.
really inclusive and caters to anyone at every price point. So you really don't have to break the bank. Mm-hmm. to get into beauty.
Nice.
Yes. So today we have some products that we're going to be talking about that we do consider kind of, you know, within that range when we think from end-to-end and high-low. So here's one of our favorite items. This is the Revlon One-Step Paddle Dryer. It's a dryer and styler all-in-one.
Love it.
Yes. So, I mean, that's one of the things that I can tell you, like doing my hair, not my favorite thing to do. So the fact that there's a tool out there that you can do it all in one is pretty revolutionary, I think. We also have here featured our MAC Satin Lipstick. So a great way to get really great satiny coverage and a nicely defined lip. And then over here, we've got our Frida Kahlo exclusive for Ulta Beauty. That's part of our very own Ulta Beauty collection. It's a three-piece kit that has the eyeshadow, the switching pan, and the collector's box.
Beautiful.
Yes, very, very gorgeous. Up here, some of our favorites. So a couple of items I'd highlight here. This particular item, definitely a favorite of mine, the Bumble and Bumble Thickening Dry Spun Texture Spray. Just a really great way to get some extra volume and hold and texture for the entire day. Additionally, right, one of our favorite perfumes is the La Vie Belle by Lancome. And here you see the full size, 3.4 ounce. But what's really great about this is if you want to get into fragrance and you want to just trial and error, you can start out introductory kind of with the roller ball. So we offer roller balls in all of our fragrances. So you don't have to commit to the large bottle at the higher price. You can really get into fragrance at that lower end and enjoy and try different fragrances as well. A couple of other products I'd highlight, we've got our Kate Somerville. This is really a terrific product. It's our makeup setting spray. So, you know, when you do all that effort to put on that makeup, you want to go ahead and set it for the day. What I really love about this is it's got an SPF of 50 in it. And again, when I think about being on the island and the sun exposure, this is just a great, again, kind of all-in-one. And then from our Kylie skin collection, we have our vitamin C serum. And so important, as we all know, is taking care of our skin. And vitamin C is really essential to that. And then I'll talk about one last item here. This is our Revolution Luxury Baking Powder. So sounds kind of interesting, but it's really terrific powder to give you kind of that flawless kind of finished look, and one again that you can get into at a very nice entry price point.
Love it. And I love that there's such a broad range because like you said, it's all about high-low. You can mix lower-end products with higher-end products.
Absolutely. And one of the things that you don't see here, but we also offer services in skin, brow, and hair in all of our Ulta Beauty stores as well. And when you look at the menu, we have some really quick, easy, fast services that you can get at an entry-level price point all the way up to some of the bigger services that we do as it relates to, you know, hair, skin, and brow.
That's so awesome. Well, thank you, Amy, so much for showing us all of the high-low and what you can get here at Ulta Beauty at every price point.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back. Well, that's our show for today. I hope you were as inspired as I was. This is the beauty of being able to do a show like Modern Wahine Hawaii, is that when you do a show for women, about women, we're able to really develop the stories that maybe some other people don't find as significant. I'm very privileged and thankful to be able to focus on diversity and letting people tell what their idea of beauty is, because there's many different standards. So thank you to Huguette and her adorable couch Petunia for letting us come down. Thank you to Cora and Cora Dorables because she inspires every single day with what she is doing with her beautiful clothing, as well as just living her life and showing people that it is possible. Thank you to Ulta Beauty because they are inspiring everyone with diversity of beauty across the board, and we are very privileged to be a part of that. Thank you so much to Inspiration Interiors for this beautiful set, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next week.
Modern Wahine Hawaii was filmed on location at Inspiration Interiors, Hawaii's best value in home furnishings.